Hey, what's up everyone? This is Luis with Super Dubai, and I'm going to show you how to replace the blades on an ice shaver that we sell. First thing you're gonna notice here is that we have two blades. We have a screwdriver, Phillips, of course, an L key, and then the actual machine itself. This process is fairly simple, shouldn't take more than 5 minutes to actually replace. Alright, so first thing you have to do is notice where all the screws are gonna be at, and the ones you're gonna remove are pretty out there, pretty easy to get. So there's one screw here, one screw at the very top, one screw on the other side, and one screw at the bottom here. On top of that, there's two more screws down here. So all those screws need to come out first. So let me go ahead and do that. Okay, so that's the four screws here. So you're still not done, you still have to get the ones down here. So these are a little more tricky, but shouldn't take long. So it's gonna take a little while longer. It's a little hard here on this side. There we go. So once all these screws are off, you're gonna take off this top cover here, which is gonna expose the blade. Okay, so take a look at the blades and the way they're positioned on there. Just make sure that the blades are facing out this way so it'll shave the ice. If they're on the opposite side, then that means you put them on wrong. So just make sure you know where these blades belong before you put them on or take them off. Alright, so in order for you to remove these blades, there's going to be two screws at the very right here at the blade. So you just basically have to loosen up these screws, and you don't have to take them off all the way. It makes the process much easier. So just loosen these up a little bit. Okay, here goes the first one. There goes the second one. So everything's good here. So these blades are officially removed from here. Okay, so we're gonna replace them with new blades. Make sure this pointy side is in first. So if you actually leave that pointy side outside, it's gonna stick out from here, and then the actual cover itself is not gonna be able to go in. So make sure they're going in this way. Actually this way. Oops. Here we go. So you have to be careful with these as well. The blades are sharp, so there's a possibility you could cut yourself if you're not being careful with this. Okay, here we go. That's one. Okay, so the blades are installed on this already. So one thing I would recommend for you guys to do before you even install the cover on this is actually wipe this down and clean them up as good as you can. This is stainless steel, so it should be fairly easy to clean. If you want, you can use disinfectant on this, which is actually something I would much rather recommend. So now that the blades are installed, the only thing left is to reinstall this cover. So here we go. There it is. Okay, so top four screws are on here. It's very important that you put in these screws from the bottom here. As you notice that this is wobbling back and forth. So if you don't put these on, then the actual machine won't be stable and could actually break. This one. Oh, this is a tricky one. So everything is in there. So next thing to do is actually test the machine, make sure the blades are spinning properly. So if you look in there, you'll notice the way these blades are shaped. So if I turn this on, it should actually go counterclockwise. And yeah, that's how it is, and everything's good here. So just make sure you use all safety precautions, and if you have any questions, send us a message or email. Thanks.